Andrew Wasson from CreativeGuitarStudio.com. In this video, I'd like to discuss whether or not it's necessary right now for you to know and understand a lot of music theory. You know, for a lot of guitar players, this area is pretty weak anyhow. Many guitarists, you know, learn A minor pentatonic or something like that in the very beginning as their first scale. Then they'll discover that they can kind of slide that around, move it around the neck laterally, and it'll figure out other locations for other keys. From there, a lot of times, quite often, what happens is the key of E minor will come into the mix, maybe a couple of other subsequent keys after that. But you know, that's kind of the earliest and most basic information that a lot of guitar players will learn, and then they a lot of times also will just hash out that little bit of knowledge for many years to come. So if it's possible to just use a few pentatonic scales for years, is it really necessary to go a lot further with the study of scale and chord theory and music theory? For a lot of guitar players, scales and chords are nothing more than just shapes on the fingerboard anyway, and more often than not, technical ability seems to play a bigger role for guitar players than music theory anyhow. However, you know, there is that element of it all that if a guitarist continues to play for long enough, and then of course, you know, if and when they are hit finally with situations that they feel they get lost in, they can't grasp the concepts that they're in certain musical situations, then, you know, at that point, they tend to want to begin study of music theory. So let's have some fun here and look at an example. Let's say, you know, something like you're playing in a band, and you get asked to perform a short guitar solo over some really common sounding chord progression. Something maybe like in a style of classic rock, maybe it's country, perhaps it's even a blues riff or something. Let me show you an example of what I mean. I'm gonna do riff right now in the key of G and demonstrate what I'm talking about. Wasn't too bad. It's pretty basic. We could just grab some G major pentatonic, have some fun over those chord changes, play over quite easily. But what do you do if things get more complicated than that? You know, what do you do if you encounter a progression with, let's say, more complex chord and scale theory? I'm going to give you an example of a progression like that right now, and you can learn it and go through it. Even, you know, hopefully you know the chords, but you're going to have to, you know, understand the chord setup. You're going to have to know how the music theory is taking place, and you're gonna have to understand how to play over it. It's gonna require some modes and a little bit more advanced theory, some arpeggios, stuff like that. Let me play this riff for you and give you an idea of what I'm talking about. Obviously, that second chord progression I just played, that's more complicated than our first chord progression. And when chords and ideas of theory, when they're applied and they get more complex, what happens is a guitar player who's not educated in it can't find the relationships to what's going on. They can't understand the leeway that's happened between standard diatonic harmony and what's happening in a more advanced sense. Most guitarists who would be uneducated with higher levels of theory wouldn't know what to do. They'd be lost on a complex progression like that. Many of them wouldn't even know how to make the chords that would be involved with the progression, never mind analyze it and understand what scales to be able to play over that as well. So normally, when progressions get more theoretically complex, the chords and what you would do to create a guitar solo can really throw a curveball your way. So this brings us right back to where we started of the question, you know, how important it is for you to understand music theory right now for the place that you're at this time. You know, more importantly, is it the right time to begin learning more advanced levels of theory? And if so, which ones specifically? You know, if you're just jamming on basic chords and that's all you do, if the progressions you play never leave the sound of diatonic harmony, then maybe you don't need to spend several weeks learning about advanced scale application, advanced brass chords, non-diatonic theory and harmony. Plus, on top of all that, you're going to need to also spend several more months afterward just practicing how to play lead guitar over those situations. It's going to be a lot of work, and you got to decide if you're going to be motivated enough to do that work. You know, everything comes down to how much time that you have to invest in this stuff. And if you feel like it'll be something that'll benefit you and you can start to apply it in the music that you enjoy right now, then probably it's time to start the theory. If you don't think in any way that you're going to apply it, you know, maybe it's not really worth it. So really, it all boils down to if there's a value and if there's a worth in doing the type of studying that's going to lead you to more advanced theory topics. And if there is, then it, by all means, it's fantastic. Pursue it and start using it right away. Because if you are pursuing that type of study, but you have no clue where on earth you'd ever apply it, it's really going to probably just be information that fades away. So if you stop and think about all this, the entire topic that we have here that we're discussing is actually a much bigger issue than you likely thought when we started the discussion here in the first place. Because if you have no motivation and no real tangible reason to study an advanced musical topic, and if you examine the playing situations that you're participating in at the moment, and you realize that you're never going to play music that uses these kinds of advanced topics, the answer is probably just really, it's perfectly okay to leave information alone that's more advanced and that doesn't really relate to where you're at as a player right now. Eventually, as you play more and you get involved in more situations, it'll become pertinent. But, you know, if at the time you can't find any reasoning of why to apply it, then you may find a lot of trouble being motivated to study it. Now, of course, this doesn't really apply if you're attending a music college or maybe you're working on your bachelor's degree in music at a university, because in those cases, you're there for a reason. You're there to become very broad-based in your knowledge, and you're trying to soak in as many different directions musically as you possibly can. It's a different stage of the game than as if you're, you know, somebody just practicing at home or jamming out with your friends. So otherwise, you know, save the learning of advanced topics for when you feel that you'll be able to apply them, because you'll get much more out of them that way, and you'll remember them longer. You'll retain them and be able to use them better. And work on topics that you feel like you're going to be moving past any weak zones that you have right now. Improve those topics first, and especially if they directly relate to the music that you normally perform or that you write or that you record with your own immediate musical network of musicians. Well, I hope that this discussion on whether you need to know music theory right now has helped you to better understand where you're at and what topics are most important to you at this moment. That was really my underlying goal with making this video. There's a lot of subjects and topics of study out there to learn when you're in the world of music training and guitar education. There's also a lot of guitar technique and music philosophy with respect to composing music. Plus, let's not leave out the rhythm education. That one's often neglected. So divide your learning into compartments. You know, really think of your education on this instrument as subjects with groups of underlying topics for each one. And be sure to do all that in combination with asking whether you're going to be able to immediately apply what you learn. You know, that type of an approach will be the best way to really start improving your guitar playing skills. Well, if you'd like to learn more about how to really zero in on specific areas of your guitar playing, join my website as a free member and start reviewing my guitar courses. They cover a ton of specific information on improving general and advanced playing skill. There are dozens of lesson plans with very detailed videos, along with PDF worksheets that you can download and print out and start covering all types of exercises for music theory, rhythm training, technical drills. Covers a lot of information there. The lessons are all very well planned. They're easy to follow, and they work in a very organized way, so that in the end you'll increase your knowledge of playing guitar and you'll be able to start incorporating more higher end guitar skills, so the music that you're playing sounds basically better and you enjoy it more. As always, I want to say thanks for joining me. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more, and remember to hit that bell when you subscribe. Until next time, take care, and we'll catch up again on the next video. Bye for now. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.